The Shock Trauma Center at the University of Maryland is the highest volume trauma center in the United States. And the types of injuries that we see here oftentimes are not seen in other trauma centers, or not seen to the extent that we have them day after day after day.
So the role of the anesthesiologist when the patient first arrives is to participate with the trauma surgeons and the nurses in the initial assessment of the patient, with a particular focus on the airway, that is making sure the patient is getting enough oxygen and is exhaling carbon dioxide. And then we would participate in the overall management of the patient with the trauma surgeons and the other members of the team.
Now, anesthesiology really has an important role in the management of the traumatized patient. You know, if you look at the overall approach that we apply, it's really a team approach. And every specialty brings certain elements to the management of these patients, to their initial assessment, that's vital to getting good outcomes. And again, that a lot of that for the anesthesiologist derives in our concepts of resuscitation, early and aggressive airway management, and also making and smoothing that sort of perioperative transition from the initial point of care, reception to the hospital, to the operating room, to the intensive care unit, or to other locations in the facility where they need to be managed with hands-on care.
Trauma anesthesiologists are an integral part of everything we do. It starts when the patient gets here, and it continues really all the way through their care. Unlike many places, the anesthesiologists are really part of the frontline resuscitation team.
Every day that we come to work only for trauma. So it's not that we're farmed around to different divisions. And so we get a chance to focus on the actual science and academics of trauma care. And so there are perhaps some people who feel that anesthesiologist's role in trauma is just to replace the blood loss and turn the gas on. But if you do this every day, you realize there's actually a science to it, and there's a lot to be learned about resuscitation. And so it makes it very unique that we can be the academic epicenter for our trauma anesthesia care.
I think the care provided here at the R. Adams County Shock Trauma Center, with the team approach that we use, with the equipment that we have available, and the speed with which we can get people from the point of injury to our resuscitation unit and into the operating room or into whatever level of care they need, it absolutely makes a huge difference. So recently we had a patient who had experienced a gunshot wound. Surgeons had obtained films prior to the patient coming to the OR. Relatively unstable, so ongoing resuscitation. And looking at the chest x-ray, I noticed that there was sort of a density over the heart. Turned out, you know, I thought it looked like a bullet. The surgeon thought it might be an EKG lead. The patient ended up getting a thoracotomy, found out that the bullet had actually traveled through, a fragment had traveled through and gone through the right atrium of the heart. So this is a patient who could have potentially died if we didn't have that relationship where I knew what to look for, and then she trusted my opinion, went ahead, and you know, the patient actually ended up having a good outcome.
The Division of Trauma Anesthesiology at Shock Trauma is a fabulous place to work because everyone works together so well. We all have very different backgrounds and very different outside interests, but when we come to work, it's everyone working together as a team and basically as one unit.
Each situation is different. It's usually like maybe a high pressure situation in the sense that each patient comes with different comorbidities, each injury is slightly different. And so each time you have to make a different plan, you have to weigh the risks and the benefits.
The things that we do help contribute to a positive outcome and really make a difference to the patients who come into the trauma hospital.
It's not for everybody, but it's for us, and there are a whole bunch of us that actually like doing this, and we're going to keep doing it for a long, long time.